Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we are not going to talk. Today we are not going to have the gameplay action. I'm sorry, but today we are going to have general tips, tricks, how to go through the ranked battles. If you are going to do that, and I will explain you some strategies which I am using myself, and there is quite some of them. So, first of all, what the flying F is ranked battles, how it's working, and what this thing is all about. So first of all, speaking about the ranked battles, how you're entering there, usually the situation for everyone and for every one of us in the garage is like this. We are prepared for the random battles. If you want to enter to the ranked battles, you are pretty much clicking klukst right there and you are ready to go. And how is it working? So pretty much there is four stages: qualification, division third, division second, and first division, right? That's how everything is looking like. So qualification, every single of you can go through qualification, right? You need to pretty much play 20 battles. Better you will play in qualification, more chevrons you will receive, more bonus battles you are going to get. Bonus battles is the games when you are getting 2 chevrons for 1 victory. So for example, you won the game, you are one out of top 3 players out there, so pretty much you are getting, instead of 2 chevrons, you are getting 4 chevrons, but there is a daily victory, and soon we will get to the fun part right there about the strategy and everything, how am I doing this and how you can do this too. Anyways, you are going through qualification, then you are starting the division third, right? You are getting all sorts of stuff from bonds, from credits, more credits, more bonds, and credits, and bonds. I mean, a lot of interesting stuff, and then you are getting the 750 gold, 500,000 credits, 800 bonds, but this game mode can be annoying, I must admit that. I was watching the other streamers yesterday who was playing ranked battles in the EU server, and I saw like pretty much 12 against 12 chieftains, or 10 against the 10 chieftains, plus on top of that the 279s. Looks like in EU server it's madness. In Russian server, as I noticed, it's more casual, it's let's say like that, easier and way more enjoyable, let's put that in this way. Anyways, whenever you are finishing the third division, you are getting to the second division, and from the second division you are getting all sorts of stuff once again, like bonds, credits, all sorts of stuff. And after that, when you are finishing the second division, you are getting 1000 bonds, 750 gold, and 750,000 credits, plus on top of their tokens. We will go there very, very soon. Give me a second, I want to explain you everything, right? So right here we have first division, so last 15 ranks and you are pretty much done with the ranked battles, right? So once again, you are getting the same shit once again. You are getting the credits, boosters, whatever, and then you are getting 2000 bonds, 1000 gold, and 1 million credits. Hip hip hooray. Now, for what you are using those tokens, right? There is a store. Season leaderboard. Did someone completed ranked battles already? Not yet. Looks like no one completed the ranked battles yet. Interesting. Anyways. Yes. So annual rewards, as you can see, for each prestige you are getting the tokens, and after that you can spend those tokens to receive all sorts of boxes and so on, so on. Pretty much you need 17 rank tokens points in order to get the new tank. As you can see, I don't even know what kind of tank this is, but pretty much you can get yourself a new toy, but you need to play quite a bit in the ranked battles. And like I said before, it's not the most, how to say that, the most interesting gaming experience, or the most pleasant gaming experience. Enough about that, enough about the rewards. what is my strategy when I'm going through the ranks? So there is a couple of things. There is three ways how you can go, okay? If you have many... First of all, let's talk about my way. How am I going to go through the Russian challenge, ranked battles, or... however to say that, right? So look, as you can see, I'm currently on the Division 2, and I am today I'm going to finish the Division 2nd, and I won't start the 1st Division. The main reason why you are getting the bonus points, right? Currently I have 20 bonus battles, but I have only 3 tanks. What that basically means, since I have only 3 tier 10s, I am using that bonus battle as a daily victory, and pretty much I cannot get the double with the same tank all over again, right? So you need to switch the vehicles. By switching vehicles, if you have those bonus battles, you are getting extra chevrons, so you are simply progressing faster. So what I decided to do, I decided to not use any of those bonus battles pretty much till this stage over there. And from now on, I will start using those those bonus battles, and I will go through through this league like a hot knife through the butter. This is my strategy, okay? I collected all those points over there in the end. And by the way, when you are prestiging, you are getting 12 bonus victories each time. If you have many tanks, you can pretty much deal with ranked battles just easy peasy like this pretty much in one day. If you have two days, if you have a lot of premium tanks, a lot of tier 10 vehicles with which you can deal with which you can go into the battle and simply get rid of the bonus battle victory. So here you go, this is how I think I'm going to deal with this, and I have my strategy out there. So I won't know life ranked battles. I will play only for doubles, and I will simply stop it whenever I will hit the gold league. This is the plan. Speaking about the EU server, at least for me, it's going to be a twist, okay, for the EU server for me. So what I decided to do, I decided to have the tank request ranked battles. And I have seen how it's looking like a lot of chieftains, a lot of 279s, a lot of other very, very strong shit in the game. Let's say like that. And when people is going to ask tanks like IS-4, like 121, or Chinese tank destroyer, or something very, very terrible, oh. This is going to be a challenge, and this is going to be bloody a hard thing to finish everything. I'm still considering my life choices. Do I actually want to do that or not? Because I want to believe this might be extremely painful, and this might be extremely, let's say like that, not the most pleasant gaming experience. That's what I want to say. Anyways, fellas. The different tips how you can get through the ranks, right? So when you are finishing qualification, right, play with one or two tanks until you will get up to the rank 12 or rank 13, right? And then start playing with the different vehicles, and you are going to use your chevrons in the left, in the right. You're going to get chevrons from the left and from the right, if you get the point what I'm saying. So you are winning battle with a new tank, you are getting double chevrons because of the double daily victories or whatever. So you can progress through those four last steps easy, and then repeat the same thing. Go pir up to 11 or up to 12 or up to 13 rank, and then repeat everything once again. Play with the vehicles which you haven't played today, or wait for another day and simply get your daily victories, and that's how you can progress through the ranks faster. Same goes right there, grinding your way up to the up to, let's say like that, rank 11 or rank 12, and then playing for double victories. Do maths in your head and figure out which kind of strategy is working the best for you, fellas. Once again, this is my advice from my side. I hope you found this stuff interesting and everything. Also, fellas, what tanks I am playing in there? I forgot the most important thing, okay? I forgot the most important thing. Don't mind me, I just woke up, fellas. I hope you will understand me, and I'm trying to give you as much knowledge from my point of view as I can. So, one of the most important things which I forgot to talk about is tanks with which you need to play in the ranked battles. This is the most important thing and question which every single of you is waiting for, right? Listen, fellas, there is no such a thing as a recipe with what kind of tanks you need to play. What do I mean by saying that? Imagine situation. I am saying for someone, listen, Piotr, Progetto. Go and play with Progetto. And Piotr hates Progetto. Piotr hates medium tanks. Piotr is enjoying his gaming experience with IS-7, and he's having a good time while playing with this vehicle. You get the point what I'm trying to say right there? So pretty much you are the judge with what kind of tanks you are playing. Play with a tank which you are enjoying the most. So if it's Super Conqueror, let it be. If it's IS-7, let it be. If it's 277, play with 277. And it doesn't matter if you like the same Foch B. If you like it, play with it. Because the most important thing right there is you need to play with a tank with which you are playing the best. And this is the most important thing, and this is most important advice from my side. Because if you will play with a tank which you are not enjoying or which you don't really like, then you will feel tortured and you are going to feel not so well. Anyways, fellas, this is my tips and tricks from my point of view, from my side, and how am I dealing with the ranked battles in general. I hope you find this video informative and enjoyable. I know some of you know this, some of you don't know this, but I need to share this information with every single of you, fellas. Okay, thank you so much for watching. See you next time, fellas. Skill is out. Peace.